elimination round. There are 32 questions and they're MCQ type. There's no negative marking and four teams will be selected based on their scores. In case of tie, we'll have additional 5 questions. You'll be having 30 minutes for 32 questions. Please read the question paper carefully. Guys, please settle down fast. Papers there. We'll be discussing the answers. So for the first 7 questions were dummy questions for the Quizmaster's delight. So we'll be scoring based from the 8th question onwards. We had a instruction written over there. Okay. Sorry. No, that was a dummy question. It didn't have an answer. Yeah, there's no negative marking. Can we go to the 8th question directly? And there was no answer to that question. No, all 4 of us are quiz organizers, all the options. Okay, so in question 8, there's been a printing mistake. Dr. Bhavaskar is from Mahad, not from Satara. And Raghudari. Yeah, so he has pioneered on research for scorpion bite, management of scorpion bite. For the next question, when the windshield shattered and one of the fragments went into the eye of the pilot actually had cataract and he got an intraocular lens by that accident, and that's how the IOLs were developed. So it was PMMA, polymethyl methacrylate. They were the first generation IOLs. No, no one removed the cataract. Okay, for the next question, the American scientist, he worked on a cardiac emergency and he developed a surgery. And when he suffered from the same condition, he was operated by his own surgical procedure. So that was D. Becky, and he gave aortic dissection. He worked on aortic dissection. D. Becky's classification and D. Becky's surgery. For the 11th question, this was the D, aortic dissection. For the 11th question, this was basically the first antisyphilitic agent, Salvarsan. For the next question, answer is 11A, syphilis. 12th question, the female banded crate venom. The molecule isolated was restriction endonuclease. So we use that for, where do we use it? Yes, recombinant DNA. For PCR, we don't use restriction enzyme, we use heating techniques. For question 13, we are describing basically Legionella pneumophila infection. It started from air conditioning of the hotel. Bhai, stable rakh usko. After I finish each slide, go ahead. So Cullen's sign, we call it for acute hemorrhagic pancreatitis classically, but it was described originally for a ruptured ectopic pregnancy. And so Dr. Cullen was actually an obstetrician. Yes, for this case, no, it's actually meningitis, Neisseria meningitis. Okay, I'll give 15 correct for any option which has been marked. 15 will be given correct. That's a mistake. We have an oral vaccine for Salmonella. We have an oral vaccine for cholera. Yeah, so cholera, it is debatable whether we give antibiotic prophylaxis or not. Yeah, the answer is wrong. The answer's MCQ option is wrong, so I have to give it correct to everyone. Okay, so question 16, azelaic acid, it was isolated from Malassezia furfur. That is the reason why there is depigmentation around a lesion. So it was originally isolated from a pityriasis patient. Yeah, this is, for this, the person, Carl Paul, he was working in Wisconsin and he named the drug after Wisconsin Association, and that's how the drug came to be known as warfarin. The WA stand for Wisconsin Association. So the Silk Road disease, it's another name for Behçet syndrome. So it would be option B. The Italian actor here is Fregoli syndrome. Because the patient perceives that all unknown people they are seeing are actually versions of someone they know. So that's Fregoli syndrome. Next question, we are basically describing the complex of Guam. It was originally described as a combination of Alzheimer's, paraplegia and dementia, but after they stopped eating that floor from false palm trees, now only dementia persists in that population. Yeah, I guess the medicine residents are very happy. This is a straight line from Harrison that I took. So yeah, question 21, this is based on the recently changed section 376 laws. So currently, anyone below the age of 18, irrespective of consent, irrespective of religion, irrespective of marital status, is a victim of rape. C. Yeah, so this was a very famous case 10 years back. Upar She's complaining of an assault. So it could be either a physical assault or a rape assault. And option D states not a rape case. We cannot say not a rape case until we examine her. Okay, question 22. This was a very famous case, I think 12 years back, where the spy was given polonium mixed in his tea. And he died of radiation toxicity. So question 23, this was in 1960s, where meat was basically responsible for bovine spongiform encephalopathy. It is a prion disease. Yeah, so coming back to Indian history, Indian surgeries, Sushruta used to use some drug for anesthesia. So yes, it was cannabis. Ether was developed in the 18th century by Gödel, and carotid compression again in the 18th century. Ignaz Semmelweis, answer B or D? Yeah, he gave the simple concept, keep a container of water and just dip your hands in it before you deliver the patient, which was not accepted by his peers. He did not give 6 steps of hand washing. He did not give concept of using soap, nothing. Yeah, so this question 26, there were some skull impressions. So I think cataract surgery would be ruled out first because it won't leave a lasting impression for so many years. This is the first surgery that was done and we still do till now. It is Burhol surgery. It was done in the Warriors when there's okay, so question 27, what's the answer? Yeah, Slim's disease. I think this has been very famous in the last week on Facebook. Second person cured of HIV with bone marrow transplant, which was done for the indication of Hodgkin's lymphoma, but it was cured for HIV. So another name would be Slim's disease. Alan Turing, how did he die? Yes, cyanide poisoning. It had nothing to do with the apple. It was not a poisoned apple. He died of cyanide poisoning. Sonali Bendre suffered from what cancer? Leukemia, no? Breast cancer, not cervical cancer. Angelina Jolie and Sonali Bendre are the two recent cases who underwent mastectomy. Robert Liston, surgery with 300% mortality. Okay, so it was done in 1800, so I think he died of infection of the wound would be an obvious answer. They didn't have antibiotics at that time. He cut his assistant's fingers and the assistant died from bleeding. So this was basically the fastest operation performed, fastest amputation in 2 minutes 13 seconds or something. He cut the patient's lower limb, he cut his assistant fingers, and a person who was standing nearby died because of the fright, seeing the blood. So that's how, answer was C. Sorry, A. Answer is A. Surgery where 3 people died when in one surgery. Yeah, so Klebsiella pneumoniae. Yeah. That is a New Delhi bug, and that's why it has been criticized, and now the nomenclature has been changed that no names of countries or cities should be used in such a case. Yeah, so sock or, yeah, okay, we don't have Dr. Sabin in the options, that's my bad. It's Dr. Sock. He had been performing some unethical experiments with influenza virus. And after that, he developed the polio vaccine also. So the answer would be A. The first position at How many we have? We had 25 questions, right? Okay, so out of 25 with 19 correct, we have Yash Sharma and Amok Pathak. With 17 correct, any guesses? Who would like to nominate themselves? Apurva Bansal team, no? I'm sorry. Manav, I'm sorry. It's Sagar Apte and Kunal Marathe. So I guess we have two post-intern teams. We are waiting for the third and fourth teams. The remaining two teams tied at 14 points. I'll start with the seniors, Dr. Balakrishna Nayak and Dr. Hemant Morparia. And the fourth team, again, we have our seniors, Dr. Nikhil Ram and Dr. Shriram. Yeah, I request all the Ascension heads and Ascension core team to settle down quickly. Okay, we are already running late. No, basically the aim of our quiz was to bring out the life of a doctor outside the wards and the hospital. So we are focusing, and since it's a humanities and ethics conference, we have tried to inculcate those components in the quiz as well. So for the quiz, we'll be having 5 rounds. So we have our team A, team white, team B is team yellow, team C is team blue, and team D would be team pink. Okay. So, and introducing the quiz master, I'm Dr. Shalin Shah. Amay Machwe and Anveshi Nayan. Okay, and for timekeeper, we have Grishma Kale, and for scorekeeper, we have Dwij Vyas. And our tech head, Nitish Garg. Okay, so we'll start with the first round. I would invite Amay to conduct the round.
So we'll start with the first round of the quiz. The pointy end. I'll read out the rules for you. Basically, this round is a round where we'll be describing a torture method, and you'll have to identify the torture method. So this is an equal opportunity round where each team has to name the torture method described. Each team has to write the answer to the question in the paper provided within 60 seconds. 60 seconds timer will start after I read out the question, or after the image has been displayed, or after the video has been played completely. And a bell will be pressed at the end of 60 seconds. Scoring pattern. If all the teams answer correctly, then each team will get 15 points. That is 60 divided by 4. So each team will get 15 points. If 3 teams answer correctly, then the 3 teams which have answered correctly, they'll get 20 points each. And the one which has answered wrong will get no points, and so on. So, and the quiz master's decision will be final. So we'll begin with the first question of the quiz. Ancient Greece was my birthplace, forged in bronze and set ablaze. Inspired by the zodiac Taurus, my sculptor was skilled, what he created got him killed. Identify the torture method. Thank you. Time up. The answer to this question was brazen bull. Brazen bull was invented by Perillus of Athens in Greece, and I'll explain you the riddle. It was of shape of a bull made up of bronze, and which was hollow from inside, and the person which was being tortured was placed inside the bull, and it was set ablaze. So the person used to get roasted and die. And when the person used to cry out from inside, then it would sound like that of a bull. And the person who had created this bull, he himself was later killed by the same torture method. So that was about the riddle. So we'll now go to the next question. No team has answered correct, so none of them get any points. Identify the torture method. Two teams have got the two teams have given the answer correct. The answer is the rack, in which the four limb, all the four limbs of the person are tied and they are pulled apart. So team A and team D have answered the question correct. So team A and team D, both of them get 30 points each. So we'll go to the next question. It's a video. Question is same, identify the torture method. So we'll tell you the results. Just a hint for the audience, this was used to torture while ragging in hostels. So the answer is wet submarine. The head of the patient is dipped in water. It is also called waterboarding. So, again, team A and team D have been able to answer the question correctly. So, both of them get plus 30 points. Now, the last question for this round. Identify the torture method. Come up. Only team A has been able to answer the question correctly. The answer to this question is parrot's perch. It was used in Brazil. So team A gets plus 60 points. Now we have a question for the audience. Identify the torture method.
get off me. I forget it ever happened. Did you know?
So anybody from the audience? Go with the simplest answer. Yeah, answer is correct. It is rat torture. So, Swamitra has had raised his hand, so he'll get the Cadbury. Swamitra will get the chocolate. And I'll pass on to Anveshi to carry forward with the quiz.
Next. So we are here with the round two. Where's my guinea pig? So sometime in the history, humans have been used as guinea pigs for experiments, though not by Einstein. The rules are as follows. Each team will be given an account of a survivor. The team has to answer within 60 seconds after the question has been read out. In case the team to which the question is directed answers this incorrectly, all the teams have to write the answer on the sheet provided immediately. Scoring pattern, correct answer will fetch you 20 points and a past correct answer will fetch you plus 10 points. There's no negative marking. It will pass from team A first, then the questions will go from team A, B, C, and then D. So for the
answer about the person on whom the experiment was done.
Name of the experiment or name of the scientist, like it will be displayed. I'll read it out. For team A, the question is, there I stood in the cage with my twin, the angel of death giving us painful injections to change the color of our eyes. With fear and anguish, I watched him torture 732 twins, injecting bacteria into them. Sometimes, some of us were cut in half and sewn back together in the hope of producing Siamese twins. Who is the angel of death in this context? Single bell will be rung at 45 seconds and double bell at 60 seconds.
Griffith.
No, that's not the answer. I request all the teams to write down the scientist's name and hand it over to Sharon, sir. Team D has got the answer correct, so they'll get plus 10 points for this round. The answer is Joseph Mengele. It was a Nazi experiment.
Next question for Team B. The Japanese overlords had defeated the Chinese Empire and held us captive. First, they would infect us, then they would cut open our limbs to study wound healing, and finally, they would rape and murder us. At the end of the war, these scientists were protected by the USA and the Chinese government in return for handing them their experimental results. What are the experiments we are referring to?
experiment on leprosy. Leprosy. Where is it?
I mean, the experiment was named after the place.
Taiwan.
So the answer to this question was Nanking experiment in unit 731 done by the Japanese. So team B was not able to answer the question, and on passing, team A and team D have answered the question correctly. So they get plus 10 points.
The next question for team C is, I was a black woman living in Maryland. 4.5 months after the birth of my child, I felt a knot in my body. At the Johns Hopkins Hospital, during biopsy of my knot, without my consent, my cells were cultured, multiplied, and the cell line was developed. Neither me nor my family had given permission for harvesting these cells. Since my cells were immortal, polio vaccine was developed using them. My cells were used in testing how parvovirus infects human cells. Which cell line am I talking about? No, the answer is incorrect. Human, can you specify, like, among the human diploids? No. Sorry, it's the incorrect answer. All the teams are requested to write the answer and submit it. Team A and Team B have got the right answer. It's the HeLa cell lines. The woman's name was Henrietta Lacks. Both Team A and Team B get plus 10 points each. And the cells were derived from her cervical cancer.
Question for Team D. I was a farmer in Alabama. I chanced upon a flyer advertising free medical care. 600 men who registered were told that they were being treated for bad blood. Many of us endured painful spinal taps, unaware that the doctors were withdrawing our spinal fluid for testing. They informed us that we would get free medicine. A white doctor would come down from the north every 3 months. When few of men died of syphilis, the white doctors offered burial allowance if the relatives would allow autopsies. What experiment was I a part of? Team D? Okay. No. Anybody from the audience would like to attempt? Ashu sir will get the chance. He raised. So that is the right answer. The answer is Tuskegee syphilis experiment, where men were tested for syphilis, and even when they were positive, they were not told about their disease. They were not given medicine, even though penicillin was available, so that they could study the progression of the disease. So Yeah, so we are done with first two rounds of the quiz. I request the scorekeeper to announce the scores.
So the scores are Team A at 140 points, Team B at 10 points, Team C at 0 points, Team D at 80 points.
Excuse me? Yeah. So three past questions. Huh? So it's
10, 10, 10. Is that
Team AA? Okay, so we start with the third round. It's a TARDIS, it's a time machine. We'll be going into the future of medicine. And I request all the teams to be very specific with their answer. We are describing some branch of medicine, or we are describing some new development. So be specific for that, don't just identify the image, okay? So can we have the rules? We'll have one question for each team. This time we'll start the other way, from team D, C, B and A. The questions have two clues. We'll display the first clue, a correct answer with that will give you 20 points. If you want the second clue, you have to ask. After the second clue, you answer correctly, you get 10 points. And you'll have a total of 1.5 minutes, that's 90 seconds. In case the team doesn't answer correctly with both the clues, the other teams have equal opportunity to answer. They don't get any additional time and they get half the point. So plus 10 after one clue, plus 5 after the second clue. Okay. So we start with team D. I request the audience to please stay calm, don't get excited, and prompt the answers. Yeah, what branch of medicine, or what branch do we link all this to? I mean, what's the innovative? What do they link to? Something related to medicine? So how do you link it with something future advancement? Either medicine or surgery or obs or pediatrics. Okay, can we have the second clue? It's a robot, basically. Equal opportunity, yeah. You have to write it. Anesh, 90 seconds. Yeah, this is the second clue. So any answer? Yeah. So it was describing the Da Vinci machine so we'll give you plus 10 points for robotic surgery, and none of the other teams get any points. So you just said Da Vinci robot. Yeah, that was the Da Vinci robot. Okay, we give them 20 points. We go to team C. Here's your first clue. What new advancement are we referring to when we link these things? You like the second clue? Okay. Yeah, so how does it link with the images in clue A? Can you go back to clue A? How does it link with the first image? Yeah, how would reconstructing an Egyptian king help us? Egyptian pharaoh. Any answer? Okay. The other teams, can we, any answers from the audience? Yes? Yes, it's virtual autopsy. We have King Tutankhamun here. Who was the first one to under? नहीं नहीं वो उधर जाएगा चॉकलेट या वर्चुअल डिसेक्शन वर्चुअल ऑटोप्सी आइदर वे आई वुड हैव एक्सेप्टेड इट सो वी हैव इट्स 3D रिकंस्ट्रक्शन सीटी फॉर अ वर्चुअल ऑटोप्सी एंड फ्रॉम सिंस इट वाज अ पास्ट क्वेश्चन वी हैव टीम ए एंड टीम डी हु हैव आंसर्ड इट करेक्टली सो दे गेट प्लस 5 points आफ्टर द सेकेंड क्लू ओके सो Devi Manan. Manan ki tari. Manan chala gaya. Okay. So we go to team B. Here's your first clue. Okay, since it's mentioned it's a drug, you have to tell me what is the new thing about this drug that we are referring to. And what's the drug, of course? Audience, please maintain silence. If I catch Soumitra and Shreyas talking once more, I'll banish you out of the MLT. Team B, would you like the second clue? Okay, can we go to the second clue? Would you like to answer now?
GLP-1 agonist.
Something simpler. I am giving you a second chance.
Oral insulin.
Yeah, that's the correct answer. They get plus 10 points. In the first slide, we had basically how the oral insulin, it's in third stage in phase 3 trials right now. So how it will be working, it is injected through the mucosa. Yeah, do we have any doubts from team A? So team B gets plus 10 points and the question won't be passed now. Okay, so team A, here's your question. What are we referring to here?
Smallpox.
Okay, how do you correlate with the images?
Is the gender smallpox? The vaccine, the electron micrograph shown that ecovirimat is the new drug used for smallpox and is Edward Jenner.
Okay, yeah. They get plus 20 points. Tecovirimat is a recently approved drug for smallpox. And we have Edward Jenner and electron microscopy of variola virus. It's not vaccine, yeah? Can we move on to the second clue? It was a child with smallpox lesions. Okay, so we are at the end of the TARDIS time machine round. Can we have the scores?
So, team A leads with 175 points, team B with 20 points, Team C with 0 points. And Team D with 105 points.
Okay. So the next round is audiovisual round. Drishyam, visuals can be deceptive. Can we have the rules for this round? This is basically a buzzer round. Each team will be given a buzzer. We have a trip circuit here, so only the team who presses the buzzer first, only that bulb will light up. There will be two visuals, that is images, and there's a question after them which I'll be reading out. I'll read out the question before the image, okay? So you have to pay attention. And we have plus 20 for each correct answer. Any wrong or unattempted or wrong answer will fetch you minus 10 points. Any doubts? And please be very specific with your first answer. What I hear first would be the correct answer. Would be the first answer. Okay. So, can we check the buzzers? Team A. Okay. No, there's one more round after this. Yeah, so Team A, please check the buzzer. Just wait a second. Yeah. Please press the buzzer. Yeah. And I request the teams to press the buzzer only once. We are thankful to the physio department for handing us these buzzers, and we don't want them to be broken when we hand them back. Team C, blue, and Team D. Yeah, it's orange or red. Okay, so for the first question, you have to name the scientist that correlates with the five things that have been mentioned. Okay, so Team B. Yeah, it's Hutchinson. Hutchinson's sign, that is herpes zoster lesions on the nose, suggests ophthalmic nerve involvement. Hutchinson's teeth in congenital syphilis. Hutchinson's pupil in extradural hemorrhage. Hutchinson's textbook of clinical medicine and Hutchinson's progeria. So Team B gets 20 points, plus 20. Now we go to the second question. You have to identify the device which was used in past. Team C. Okay, just a minute. We'll check the buzzers again. Team A. Oh, lose okay, first. Team C, okay. Team D. Team D, can you please press the buzzer? Okay. Team A. Team B. Okay. So, yeah, Team C have answered it correctly. They get plus 20 points. Answer is iron lung. It was used for polio patients in whom the intercostal muscles were paralyzed. So this helped in breathing. So there are very few patients who are alive who are still on iron lung. So for the next four questions, they are videos. Okay, where we are at some ethical crossroads. So at the end of the video, there'll be a question which has a yes or no answer. The points will be given for a proper justification, not for just a yes or no. Okay, and a proper justification will give you plus 40 points. So this is a huge way to cover up. And a negative answer or a random answer without a proper justification would be minus 20 points. So, should we start with the first video? Start. boys, volume. Full. ये क्या हुआ? सुनो, no pulse friend, starting CPR.
He has do not resuscitate tattoo, should be performed CPR or not?
Team A. Yes, answer.
Having a do not resuscitate order tattooed on him means that he was fully aware of what he was giving the order for, and that it is a tattoo is supposed to be permanent. So he knew and his decision was final. He could have changed that decision, of course, later on. So no, don't resuscitate.
Okay, I would give that minus 20. Since a tattoo is not a valid legal document, so that could have been a murder and the tattoo may have been given after the person died, or the person could have been poisoned and the tattoo may have been given after it. It's not a valid legal document, and most important point, there's no valid signature of the patient. So if ever there is a do not resuscitate document with the signature of the person, only then it is considered. Yeah, it cannot be used for such cases. It's basically we go for any person who is chronically ill and he goes into arrhythmia or something, then there's two witnesses and the patient or something. Okay, so team A gets minus 20, okay? So we go to the second video. Can you have the second video, Nitish?
Vaccines do not work and they never did. Vaccines are the tools of Illuminati to sterilize poor children and to depopulate Earth. I read an article by Dr. Wakefield, which stated that vaccines cause autism. Vaccines contain harmful chemicals like mercury, aldehyde, and aluminium. So I will not vaccinate my children.
Should we vaccinate his child or not?
Should the doctors vaccinate the child or not? When the parents are against vaccination, that is the anti-vaxxer movement, if the parents belong to the anti-vaxxer movement. So team B among
so, yeah, so if the parents are not giving consent for vaccination, then we cannot vaccinate the children.
Yes or no?
So we won't vaccinate the children if parents don't allow.
Okay, I understand you are studying for USMLE, so you are answering based on the US guidelines. For India, the law gives consent for vaccination for the mandatory vaccines. So whether the parent agrees or not, the patient has to be vaccinated. So for the US, I agree with you, the Supreme Court has ruled in the favor of the parents. The parents know best about the children. But for India, it is still, the law gives consent for all mandatory vaccines. So team B gets minus 20.
We go to the third video.
Can you have the third video?
I'm Suresh.
And I'm Ravesh. We are a couple.
And we want to have a child
volume
with the donor
over. Will the Indian surrogacy laws allow us?
I am Suresh.
And I am Ravesh.
Hi.
We are a couple.
And we want to have a child with the donor over.
Will the Indian surrogacy laws allow us to go through with this?
I am Suresh.
And I am Ravesh. We are a couple.
And we want to have a child with a donor ovum.
Will the Indian surrogacy laws allow us to go through with this?
Was it clear? Okay, I'll be speaking the entire thing. Please don't press the buzzer still. I'm Suresh and I'm Ramesh and we are a couple. We want to have a child with a donor ovum. So will the Indian surrogacy laws allow us to go through with this? Okay, we go to team B.
Currently, the commercial surrogacy, if it's not a relative or not someone known, is not allowed according to Indian laws, so we cannot go according.
Okay, just the commercial surrogacy is the problem here?
No, obviously, because the commercial surrogacy was the major problem because from foreign. Yeah, the donor is not, it should be a relative because people from foreign used to come and, like, if it's not related.
Okay.
And homosexuality, the same sex.
Okay, we'll give them plus 40. The current surrogacy laws allow only a married male and a female who have not had any prior children to go for a surrogate option. The donors should be relatives. The surrogate can be a commercial surrogate. It's not only a relative, but it has to be a married male and female who have not had a prior children. I have not had a prior child. So plus 40 to team B. And the last video of Drishyam.
I need to tell you something. I'm pregnant.
What? We don't have money. We need to abort.
But I want to keep this baby.
You can either have me or the baby.
Then I choose the baby. But I'll make you pay for it.
Is the husband legally liable to pay for child support in this case? Question was, is the husband legally liable to pay for child support? In such a scenario, anyone? Okay, no one. Anyone without any points, no negative, no positive? Just attempt. Anyone in the audience, you want to attempt? Yeah, no negative, no positive.
Yes.
Explain.
The father is liable regardless of whether he wants to keep the child or not, because after birth, if a paternity test is done and even if the father does not know that the child exists, the father is still liable. So in this case, obviously the father is going to be liable. You cannot deny liability by saying that you wanted to abort the child.
It's not about the rights of the mother or the father, it's about the rights of the child. Child has rights to proper parental support and proper upbringing. That's why both the mother and the father are responsible for equal contribution. So usually in the Indian laws, mother is given the custody, so the father has to pay for child support, that is alimony. That's right.
What I think is, at present, if there is no agreement between the father and the mother, the mother can continue with the pregnancy, but in that case, father will not be liable to pay for that child. Because fathers can actually, if the mother terminates, say for example in the reverse way, mother terminates pregnancy and father wants the child, he can sue the mother. So it's like that. So I think it is different.
We actually referred to, it was in the mid-2000s when Supreme Court gave an order, so we are not aware of any some changes. Okay. So either way, according to the recent, it would have been a no, so it would have been wrong. So thanks, Dr. Padmaja, for the insight. Can we have the scores?
I'll start from the bottom. Okay. Team A is the highest with a score of 155. Team B with 60 points. Team C with 20 points. And Team D with 105 points.
Moving on to the next round. Let's all go back to our childhood and play some hangman. So, the rules are, each team has to select an alphabet from the ones projected. A clue will be displayed on the screen, then the answer to which will start with the chosen alphabet. Each team gets 5 chances to guess the correct alphabet or the correct answer. The time limit is 2 minutes. The scoring will be, it's changed from plus 30 to plus 70, plus 50 points, okay? There's no passing allowed, and the quizmaster's decision will be the final. We'll start with the team having the lowest score, that is team C. We'll display it. Which letter do you want? No. It's a non-passable round. Show you where the alphabet is there in the answer. S. S. So, when British Navy ships ran out of firewood, they used to burn any books available with them, except for the pages pertaining to this one topic. So, you have to guess what the topic is.
Scurvy.
It's correct. So, teams. Team C gets plus 50 points. Can we go back? Yeah. For team B. Can we have the clue for C? So this is the clue. A single bell at 1 minute. You can choose a letter if you want, or just directly give the answer.
O.
O. Any other letter? Can we go back to the? Yeah, you can write it down.
L.
One more minute to go.
T. Letter T. I.
The next has to be your answer.
What are you thinking of? Okay, anyone in the audience, please. Yeah, it's cholera. John Snow was the epidemiologist who made the initial survey charts for cholera.
He discovered that waterborne here. No points. Next team is next team B, which letter do you choose? D. This is the clue for it.
Answer the word.
Yeah, you can answer the word directly.
Diphtheria.
Yeah, it's correct. Team D gets plus 50 points. That was diphtheria written in different languages. So, team A. Your letter by default is A. People of Maruthichal, a village in Kerala, play chess to prevent what condition?
Alzheimer's.
E. You have three more chances left. There will be a single bell at 1 minute. One more minute left and three chances.
O.
Can we have the clues for O? You can note it down.
L.
Can we have the letter L?
Alcoholism.
That's the correct answer. Team A gets 50 points.
Okay, so we come to the end of our quiz. We would like to thank Dr. Lopa ma'am, Dr. Padmaja ma'am, Dr. Kulkarni ma'am for being here. The Department of Physiology for lending us the buzzers, our Ascension heads, Pranav Surwase and Ayushi Gupta, and my team, our tech guy Nitish, our scorer Grishma, and our timekeeper Dwij, and my co-hosts Amay and Anveshi, and myself Dr. Shalinsha. Can we have the results? We have prizes for the top two teams. We have a cash prize and some books by Dr. Manu Kothari. At second position, we have Team D, a senior most team. And at first position, we have our post interns, Team A. For the other two teams, you have chocolates. Yeah, the prizes will be arriving in few minutes. I request the audience to please maintain silence till then. Anyone has any feedback, you can please come down and share it with us. Yeah, Saumitra wants to say something. I request him to come down. Thank you. It's a team effort, so.
Okay. I have been here witnessing unfolding of the entire event for last 3 days. Of course, few scattered people here and there, which are of course like a rolling stone, they are not the same. I think except one face I see who is constant. However, whosoever is around here, I would like to tell us or give us feedback, because this entire exercise is done to sensitize students, to explore their inner strength, not to get lost in the wilderness of what next. Idhar jaun. Instead of that, if they know what makes them feel in sync or in tune with their own self. And that's why I want you people to reflect and tell us, and in fact I would request the organizers. Let me before saying anything further, the entire team, Pranav and Ayushi onwards, have done fantastic job. I don't think any, even professionally, event manager person could have coordinated the way they have done. And what remarkable thing I have observed, the variedness or varied component of the entire event. And each event was handled by one or two members. They took the entire responsibility and presented here. The last performance is one of the best examples where how these people have put in so much of effort, and of course they themselves will be richly benefited by this, because they had to put in a lot of study in any form of knowledge which enlarges your horizons never goes waste. Any piece of information which derogates you or humankind usually is negative, it robs you of, but not the positive. And that's why I have been just repeating this, that in Gandhiji's three bandars, I would like you to just modify a bit. Keep one eye closed, not to see any negative or bad all the time. But keep the other eye open to see what is best. And that best can ultimately reach divinity. Each flower unfolding, wind or breeze blowing, fragrance coming, all this can be only marvel, magic, whatever you want to see. Same thing with hearing. Keep one ear shut, especially the rumors and whatnot, anything which negates you from goodness of being, don't listen. But listen something which keeps you in tune, in sync with nature. And nature, what I mean, is the cosmic harmony. Space, air, sunlight, water, earth, all this just work in tune. In Upanishad it is said, there is a fear of disrupting itself from the sink. Sun works like that, everything. Sun works, moon works, everything, because they want to remain in sync. Bhayat, that's why they work. So if nothing else, even if just not to move out of the sink, just be, listen to your inner voice, what makes you one with yourself and not conflict. Reflect over this. We are trying to give you various kind of exposures, and even if you feel that why did I spend this time here, maybe right now you may not understand. As is true, I am sure Dr. Morparia will bear me out, that when Dr. Manu Kothari used to talk, the students that time used to feel that this is nothing, there is no anatomy. Somehow whatever he was saying, somewhere they were not gelling with it, but yet they knew that there is something in it. So they listened to all those lectures, and now they are saying that we don't remember anybody else teachers what they taught us, but what Dr. Manu Kothari spoke, now we find that it tells us what he, how much advanced he was, that what is life all about. So some of this missing, I am sorry, but most of the GSIs have not attended this class, sessions, because they all are warming benches in DAM's classes. I don't know how much they will realize what they have lost. Even if they get net rank, but how to handle that rank, how to handle that success, they will not know. So if somewhere you feel that what we are making attempts and we are trying hard, and I'm one person who does not give up. So even today morning when the thing was discussed that there is hardly any audience, I said, I don't want the whole class full, but if even 10 students are there who are sincere about attending, this then can progress in geometric progression. So this we will continue, and I first Ascension when we did, we had only 2 people working. The other students were in fact saying that we are snatching in the realm of other programs, which was not an attempt at all. 2 became 10, 12. Dr. Padmaja is witness to all this because she has been the main person who takes the entire responsibility of that everything goes in order. It is her responsibility. I am just, because of my seniority age, they all respect me and allow me to do all this, even talking about. So 2 became 15, and this year now I am seeing 15 has become 30 plus. So please spend few minutes with your own self every day. Ask yourself, what is it, what you are wanting? Material wealth will never, Amitabh Bachchan says that money is not sufficient if you can count. So dissatisfaction or asantosh will never give you satisfaction in life. The best wealth you have is santosh. So even for 5 minutes, if you can be with yourself and find out what you want in life. In fact, Jerry will agree with when I say now next, that the entire core team, when I met once, I said, I only want one thing from you, and that is smile. If you can smile at that moment, you go beyond yourself. You don't think about yourself or how miserable you are and what is missing. You establish link with the others. So if at the end of some of these sessions, if you can just learn to reach out to your own self, and thereby you can reach out to others, we have achieved a lot. Thank you very much. I'm sure Dr. Padmaja has to have the last word. She is the chief organizer from the staff. So come, Padmaja.
I'm. Yes, yes.
Okay. My one small bit. I'm very proud of you all. The way this whole 5 days has gone, 2 days of workshops and this, it's something very remarkable. Sometimes I feel if clock would rewind, we would have again been part of this. It's not to be, but really, thank you very much for participating, and it's a great exercise you all are doing, and I'm sure it's as the subsequent generations see this event, and when they want to conduct their programs, they're going to learn a lot from you. Really proud of you all. And madam just says, I'm just here because I'm senior and all that. It's not like that. She's really the life of this whole event and the whole program of medical humanity. She's very humble, humble to the fault, but it's because of her that the whole thing is running.
We have the invite the team A, our winners, Dr. Kunal Marathe and Dr. Sagar Apte. Kunal Marathe. And Dr. Sagar Apte. And I invite the runners up, Dr. Hemant Morparia.
I again thank this team which has designed this quiz. A lot of work has gone behind. And I'm right now offering them gift in words. I will fulfill it by doing converting into kind. Thank you.
The audience is requested to wait for some time. We have our last segment for today, word stories, in which seniors will narrate some interesting word experiences. So we would like to invite our first senior, Nitish sir.
Hi everyone. So I finished my internship in 2017, and since then I've been preparing and also involved in a few pursuits. Loba ma'am has always inspired me. So during my medicine posting, I used to be in ward number 9, and so it was a routine day. I was doing the pre workup in the morning around 7-8 o'clock, and a relative just came up to me and said that sir, ek patient ka Foley's catheter change karna hai. So I just went in and checked the patient, and I changed the Foley's catheter and got back to my routine work. And this kept on happening every day during my medicine posting. So whenever I used to be in the morning in the ward doing my routine blood collections and other patient work, so this guy used to come up to me and seek for some routine work for some patients, like changing Foley's catheter or IV cannula, etc. So, and over a period of time, I got curious. He kept on, these patients kept on changing, and initially I used to think that he was a relative of some particular patient. But then I, at the end of my posting, I approached him and asked him ki how was his patient, and he told me that he never had any relative admitted in the ward. So he was a retired guy, called Mr. Joseph, and he used to come to Ward 9 every day and, you know, help any patient that needed help. So he used to run errands for them. He used to go to the pharmacy store to buy medicines for them, for those who couldn't afford it, or help them in some investigations, or anything, any of the help that patients needed. So sort of he was being a caregiver for all the relatives, or for all the patients in the ward. And I was completely taken aback by, you know, his kindness. Though he had nothing to do with KM Hospital, he never had any relative admitted in the hospital, but still he used to come every day to Ward 9 to help patients just out of kindness and compassion. And this gave me, you know, sort of my lesson number one during my internship, that, you know, we take pride in being doctors or interns or residents or anything, but, you know, caregivers are so important in the recovery of the patient. And he was being a wonderful, kind, selfless caregiver when he had nothing to do with any of the patients. So during the same posting in medicine, so there was a patient of alcoholic liver disease. Multiple ascitic taps were done and still he wasn't improving. So just, you know, after my routine work, I just started talking with the patient, and I was just, you know, asking that why doesn't he, you know, stop, or why doesn't he stop taking alcohol, or what's the problem? So his wife came up to me and, you know, started crying. And I was surprised, sort of shocked. And I didn't know what to do. So she started crying, I calmed her down. And then, you know, gradually she started opening up. You know, that her husband was a chronic alcoholic, been drinking for a long, long time, for 30 years or something, multiple hospital admissions, but still he was addicted. And all of their savings, all the finances were wiped out. They had nothing. They were almost on the brink of bankruptcy. And he needed a liver transplant, but of course they didn't have anything, no savings, nothing. And though this alcoholism, okay, ALD is a medical disease, but alcoholism is also a socio-economic problem, a social problem. So even though I'm a doctor, but we sort of fragmentalize, or, you know, fragment medicine into just medicine and don't think of socio-economic problems. And alcoholism here was a social problem, and I was completely helpless. And this sort of gave me my lesson number two in my internship, that medicine is not just medicine, it also includes social medicine. Then I was after a few months, this was actually in search. So this is not just KM Ward Shori. I was in search Gadchiroli in Dr. Abhaybang's Shodhgram campus. And I'd been to one of their mobile OPDs. And you know, these mobile OPD van, they used to go up in very remote places. There was one village called Bhapada, about 30 to 40 kilometers from Gadchiroli. And the medical officer there was seeing the OPD, and one lady came up to her, the medical officer, and she was menstruating, and she started telling her story, that how her how her relatives, or how her husband and her in-laws used to completely isolate her from their home. She had a away from their home, away from their hut, she had a very dilapidated hut where she used to sit all those 3-4 days of menstruation, and with and the in-laws, the husband would, you know, like treat her as untouchable for those entire 3-4 days. And though I was trying to convince her husband, who was accompanying her, but like they had their own traditional beliefs, which was you know, ingrained since centuries maybe. So this gave me lesson number 3, that how much ever medical knowledge or clinical knowledge I might be having, or I might be, you know, like during my when I pursue PG, anthropology is something that also is a very, very close part of medicine. You cannot separate or divorce medicine from anthropology. And, you know, these 3 stories I've been reflecting, these have been, you know, somewhere deep down inside me. But, and I couldn't help but resonate to what the pathologist and anthropologist Rudolf Virchow once said, that, you know, medicine is not just medicine. Medicine is a combination of social medicine, anthropology, pathology, and politics. So we just can't use or treat medicine as medicine. It has a lot of more aspects which, you know, we can treat the disease, but like as all the great physicians say, but healthcare is something, you know, treating the whole, welfare of the whole, they say. So the whole cannot be seen, or the whole cannot be treated until you see the whole bigger picture. That's what I reflected on. Thank you.
Our next speaker for today is Ashu sir.
Hi guys. Hello ma'am. Ward stories, shayad pehle to main hindi mein bolna chahunga, comfortable ho jata hai sabko. To pehli jo cheez mere ko jo yaad aa rahi hai, mera gynec posting chal raha hai abhi, matlab aaj hai, but mera jab pehle tha tab ek patient thi, aur interns ki zindagi matlab sirf collection pe based hai. हम लोगों को और कुछ करने से पहले अरे जाके ब्लड कलेक्शन कर ले. तो सुबह सुबह अगर आप किसी गायनेक पे जाएंगे तो वहाँ पे लेडीज सबसे ज़्यादा फ्रस्ट्रेटेड होती हैं, बेचारी इतने गुस्से में, लाइक अरे क्या सुबह सुबह खून चूसने आ गए. मैं बोला अरे आंटी मैं तो अभी आया, आप क्यों गुस्सा हो रही हो? बोलते नहीं नहीं तुम ऐसे हो. मैं बोला आंटी शक्ल है मेरी, क्या करूँ मैं अभी? बोलती है नहीं नहीं मैं नहीं दूंगी खून, ये है तुम्हारा, परेशान करके रख दिया. मैं बोला ठीक है. मैं ऐसे और मैंने मजाक में बोलता आंटी हैप्पी बर्थडे. तो आंटी बोलती है तुम्हें कैसे पता? बोले क्या, लाइक मैं फाइल निकाला, ओह इट्स अ बर्थडे, और साइड में सब खुश. मैं बोला आंटी कुछ भी हो जाए, आज कलेक्शन हो ना हो, आपका बर्थडे तो बनेगा. और वो जो आंटी जी थी वो ऐसे मतलब जो भी सॉरी मैम बट जो रेसिडेंट्स है सब लोग वैसे लाइक क्या यार कौन है इनका बर्थडे कौन मनाता है. बोले नहीं मैम कुछ भी हो जाए बर्थडे तो बनेगा. तो उस दिन मेरा ओपीडी था, ओपीडी ख़त्म हुआ, उसके बाद हम लोगों ने प्लान किया, फ़ोन किया, केक आया और हम लोगों ने केक कट किया. और सच्ची बोल रहा हूँ जो सन्नाटा था वार्ड में, गायनेक वार्ड, सो इट वाज वेरी साइलेंट, लाइक एवरीवन लाइक सडनली दैट केक वाज देयर एंड दे आल्सो हैड अ केक, उनकी फैमिली की तरफ से केक आ गया. मतलब ऑल ऑफ अ सडन पूरे वार्ड में शायद मैंने रूल तोड़ दिया होगा, पर उस दिन मैंने उनका बर्थडे बनाया. और वो 20-25 मिनट मेरी लाइफ के लिए एक ऐसे मोमेंट थे. मैं शायद ऐसे खड़ा हूँ और आप देख सकते हैं आजू बाजू में जितने पेशेंट्स सुबह से लेके शाम तक सब फ्रस्ट्रेटेड रहते हैं, क्योंकि किसी को भी हॉस्पिटल में रहना पसंद नहीं है. शायद मैं डॉक्टर हूँ, अगर मैं पेशेंट बनता तो मुझे भी पसंद नहीं आएगा. तो वो उनको ऊपर से सिस्टर चिल्ला रही है, मौसी चिल्ला रही है, उनके परिवार वाले चिल्ला रहे हैं, कोई ना कोई चिल्ला रहा है, वो वहाँ पर पूरा दिन परेशान हो गए हैं. और पर उनके चेहरे पर जो खुशी थी, वो आंटी ने मेरे को अगले दिन जब मैं गया तो मुझे क्या बोला पता है? अरे खून निकाल लो ना बेटा. वो सबसे अच्छी चीज थी, मतलब वो और मेरे मतलब उनके फेस पे. और उसके बाजू में जो पेशेंट थी उनका नाम सुमन है, मेरे को इनका नाम याद नहीं है, पर जो सुमन थी वो भी आई. और अगले दिन मेरा गायनेक का एमर्ज था, तो वो मिठाई लेकर आई थी बिकॉज शी वॉज वेल, एवरीथिंग वॉज डन. सो सुमन आती है और बोलती है डॉक्टर साहब आप भी लीजिए. मैं बोला मैंने तो कुछ किया ही नहीं. नहीं 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 आपने बर्थडे बनाया था ना, अब मेरा बर्थडे आएगा तो मैं आप लोगों से मिलने आऊँगी. तो दिस इज व्हाट आई हैव बीन थ्रू. मेरे को लगता है कि ये वार्ड्स की स्टोरीज ऐसी नहीं है. पेशेंट्स के साथ कैसे आप बात कर सकते हो. मैं बहुत अच्छा स्टूडेंट नहीं रहूँगा, शायद मैं पढ़ाई में इतना अच्छा नहीं होऊंगा, पर मेरे को एक चीज़ आती है, मैं जाके लोगों से बात कर लेता हूँ, थोड़ा सा हंसाना जानता हूँ, तो वही कोशिश करता हूँ उन पेशेंट्स के साथ. तो ऐसे एक वार्ड में ऐसा था कि मैं जस्ट हेल्प करने के लिए कभी भी चला जाता था. तो मेरे दोस्त ने मेरे को बुलाया, तो किसी का पोस्ट एमर्ज था, पूरी रात सोए नहीं है, और वो कलेक्शन के लिए. तो वहाँ पे एक बाबा जी थे, कुछ 60-70 प्लस रहेंगे, और वो फुल फ्रस्ट्रेटेड, क्योंकि रोज़ ब्लड कलेक्शन किसी को भी लगाओगे तो बहुत बुरा लगता है. तो उन वो ऐसे बैठे हैं और वो गालियाँ दे रहे हैं, नाए माला नाए जाए ऐसे, हे साले काय साले लल. और मुझे पता नहीं कुछ ऐसा रहता है अंदर, कीड़ा काटता है कि नहीं भाई, उनसे तो बात करनी है, मतलब कुछ भी हो जाए वो गुस्से में क्यों है, वो दुखी क्यों है, मेरे को जाके बात करनी है. तो मैं बोला बाबा काय साले, बोले काय काय तुम्हारा काय, तुम्हारा तो रक्त घैसे ये कर, तुमको खून निकालना है, तुमको परेशान करना है, ये करना है. बोला बाबा मैं कुछ नहीं कर रहा. मैं बोलता लूंगा ही नहीं मैं, पर आपको हुआ क्या है. बोलता मेरे को ऐसा है, मैं कब से बैठा हूँ, मेरे को डिस्चार्ज नहीं दे रहे हैं, ये डॉक्टर समझते नहीं. बोला ठीक है कोई बात नहीं, आप शांत हो जाओ. नहीं नहीं ऐसे कैसे हो जाओ मेरे, मतलब ठीक अब भी मैं आपसे बात करता हूँ, अपन बात करते हैं. और ऐसे बात करते करते बोलते हैं, मैं बोला फिर देखो आपकी तबीयत ठीक नहीं होगी, तबीयत ठीक नहीं होगी तो आपको ये नहीं मिलेगा, फिर डिस्चार्ज नहीं मिलेगा. तो ऐसे थोड़ी थोड़ी देर बाद, और वो उनकी जो वाइफ थी बोलती है, हाँ आईका ना सुनो ना आप. मैं बोला हाँ बोला मुझे डांट रहे हैं. और फिर से धीरे धीरे सेटल नहीं, मैं से बोला ठीक है बाबा हम भी जाते हैं. और मेरी को इंटर्न जो उनकी इंटर्न थी, मैं उस यूनिट का ही नहीं था, मैं दूसरे यूनिट का था. तो मैं से वो कीड़ा काटा मैं जाके बात करने के लिए, तो मैं जाके घुस गया, मेरे कलेक्शन छोड़ के मैं उनके कलेक्शन करा था. मैं गया और फिर उनके वेन, ये पूरा हाथ फुल था, मतलब सूजन थी, स्वेलिंग थी, तो वेन नहीं मिल रही थी. अब तो क्या है, या तो रेडियल मारो या तो फिमोरल मारने के लिए बहुत पेन होता है. मैं बोला ठीक है अभी कुछ ऑप्शन नहीं है. सो मैं बाबा से बात करते करते, और मैंने कोइंटन को बोला तुम अपना कलेक्शन कर लो, मैं तब तक इनका देखता हूँ. मैंने बाबा को बोला देखो बाबा एक ही सुई लगाऊंगा, फटाक से ब्लड निकालूंगा. बोला नहीं नहीं ऐसा नहीं चलना. तो मैं से बोला ठीक है आपको डिस्चार्ज नहीं मिलेगा, लाइक द वे आई ट्राई. एंड फिर द ही लाइक ओके, बट एक कस प्रिक. बोला हो. और मैंने एक प्रिक डाला, एंड बाय गॉड ग्रेस वो प्रिक में एक पूरा ब्लड आ गया. मैंने बोला हो गया पापा खत्म, कभी काट ला लाइक उनको भी पता नहीं चला, फटाफट हो गया. एंड दैट वॉज आई वॉज सो हैप्पी, ही वॉज हैप्पी. नेक्स्ट डे मैसेजेस मेरे कलेक्शन ओ इकड़े आ. बोला क्या हो गया, कलेक्शन करो. नहीं तो दिस इज़ वॉट आई लर्न दैट, कि आप कितने अच्छे से बात करते हो पेशेंट से. अगर आप कैजुअलिटी में भी रहोगे जहाँ पे सबसे ज़्यादा फ्रस्ट्रेशन रहता है. और एक पेशेंट आए थे आसाम से, टाटा में थे, एंड आई वॉज ऑन द कैजुअलिटी वहाँ पे. मेरे को मैं खुद की तारीफ नहीं कर रहा हूँ, बट मैं बात करने का तरीका समझा रहा हूँ, क्योंकि मेरे बाजू में मेरा दोस्त है और वो ऐसे बात कर रहा था कि हाँ ठीक है इधर आओ, ये यहाँ पे चले जाओ, ऐसे करो. मेरे से नहीं होता बात करने का, क्योंकि मेरे को लगता है अगर मैं उस जगह पे खड़ा हो तो मैं खुद से कैसे बात करूँगा. मैंने बात की, उन्होंने बोला कि सर मैं आसाम से हूँ, ऐसा है वैसा है. मैं बोला बाबा सुनो, आप आसाम से हो, हाँ. आप इंडिया से हो, हाँ. आप दुनिया से हो, हाँ. आप इंसान हो, हाँ. तो हम डॉक्टर्स देखेंगे, आप चिंता मत करो. एंड ही वॉज सो हैप्पी अबाउट इट, उनको इतना अच्छा लगा. वो बोले ये डॉक्टर का नाम क्या है. मैं बोला बाबा डॉक्टर के नाम से क्या मतलब, ये सब डॉक्टर्स ही हैं, हम सब आपकी मदद करने के लिए हैं. आप चिंता मत करो, आप कल आ जाना, क्योंकि आज आपको ओपीडी बंद हो चुका है, कल आप आएंगे तो काम हो जाएगा. और वो कितने खुशी से गए हैं और अगले दिन आए हैं और उनका काम हुआ है. बट ही वॉज सो हैप्पी. दिस इज़ वॉट आई लर्न फ्रॉम माई इंटर्नशिप. बहुत सारी चीज़ें थी जहाँ पे मेरे को ऐसा बुरा भी लगता था, अनएथिकल वर्क रहते हैं बहुत सारे. कई बार आपको ऐसा लगता है कि यू आर नॉट गुड फॉर इनफ, कभी कभी गुस्से में आपको भी गुस्सा आ रहा था. बट एक चीज़, अगर जो फर्स्ट ईयर से भी, अगर मैं किसी को एक फर्स्ट ईयर से हैं और वो सेकेंड ईयर थर्ड ईयर जो हैं, इंटर्नशिप का फर्स्ट डे गोवंडी में मेरे को बोला कि जाके ओपीडी में बैठ जाओ, पेशेंट देखो. पहला पेशेंट मेरी लाइफ में, मैं समझा नहीं क्या चल रहा है. फाइनल ईयर तक तो सब केसेस पते रहते हैं. मैंने पेशेंट को देखा और मेरे को, मैं सच्ची बोल रहा हूँ, ब्लैकआउट हो गया. बोला अब तो क्या होगा, मेरे को डॉक्टर कुछ पता नहीं क्या है. मैं बेसिक चीज़ बोलूँगा, अगर आपने पल्स और बीपी भी देखना चालू किया ना, आई टेल यू दिस, वो कॉन्फिडेंस आपको लाइफ लॉन्ग लेके जाएगा. एटलीस्ट मैंने वहाँ पे बीपी और पल्स जो लिया, उसके बाद मैंने पूरे क्वेश्चंस जो पूछना चालू किए विद द हेल्प ऑफ द टीचर्स, आई अंडरस्टूड द मीनिंग ऑफ वॉट आई हैव लर्न इन 4.5 ईयर्स. एंड ही गेव मी अ स्माइल कि सर पहले तो कोई पूछता भी नहीं था कि बीपी लेता है क्या, पल्स लेता है क्या. एटलीस्ट मैंने एक मिनट वो पल्स लिया, उसमें वो खुश हो गए. क्योंकि हम लोग क्या करते हैं, लगाया स्टेथो बंद है कि चालू है वो भी नहीं पता, बस लगा के छोड़ देते हैं. एटलीस्ट तुम वो सब करो. अगर वार्ड्स में जाते हो तो पेशेंट के साथ 5 मिनट बैठो, अगर अच्छा नहीं लगा ना तो वो, मैं बताता हूँ, मेरा नाम चेंज कर देना. पेशेंट को सिर्फ कोई चाहिए जो उनकी बात करे, उनसे सुन ले. और मैं सर्जरी, मेरे को तो सबसे अच्छा लगता वार्ड नंबर एट में सर्जरी के, वहाँ पे सुबह सुबह सिस्टर्स गाना बजाती हैं. लाइक रेडियो चलाती है और मैं भी खुश हो गया, मैं भी ऐसा नाच रहा हूँ मस्ती में, लाइक मैं जब मैं कलेक्शन करने जाऊँ तो खुशी होना चाहिए क्योंकि आप खुश हो तो पेशेंट खुश होता है, मैं हंस रहा हूँ नाच रहा हूँ और वहाँ पे वो जो दो पेशेंट्स थी देवर ऑल्सो वेरी हैप्पी अबाउट इट, लाइक अरे डॉक्टर साहब ऐसे कैसे नाच रहे हो, बोला आप भी नाचो ना अच्छा लगेगा ना, तो दिस इज़ वॉट मेक्स देम हैप्पी, आप कितने अच्छे से बात करते हो वो आप पे डिपेंड करता है, उनको सिर्फ बात करने वाला चाहिए यार, इंटर्न्स में एटलीस्ट हम लोग वही कर सकते हैं, दवाइयाँ तो मैं मेरे से सीनियर्स हैं देने के लिए, हम लोग कलेक्शंस के अलावा बात करेंगे तो ज़्यादा अच्छा लगता है, क्योंकि एक पेशेंट मेडिसिन में था उनके पिताजी का देहांत हो गया बट वो जो उनके बेटे थे वो मेरे को जहाँ जहाँ मिले हैं, मैं ब्लड बैंक में बैठा था, अरे सर आप कैसे हो, मैं बोला सॉरी मैंने आपको पहचाना नहीं, तब मुझे याद आया कि वो पेशेंट को वहाँ पे वैसे वैसे मिले थे, तो आप कितना कि मैं यहाँ पे जूनियर्स, मेरे जूनियर्स को मैं जानता हूँ सीनियर्स को जानता हूँ पर मैं वार्ड में लोगों को नहीं जानता हूँ, पर वो लोग भी अगर आपसे जुड़ रहे हैं इसका मतलब आपने कुछ किया है तो आप लोगों से जुड़ रहे हैं, तो यही मेरे को सीखने को मिला है कि वार्ड स्टोरीज इज व्हाट मेक्स यू मोर देन अ डॉक्टर, यू शुड बी अ ह्यूमन फर्स्ट और नॉट फॉर सेल्फ, नॉट फॉर अदर्स बट वो नॉट फॉर सेल्फ बट फॉर अदर्स, दिस इज वॉट इज ऑल अबाउट, आप कितना लोगों के लिए करते हो कितना बात करते हो वो सब में ही आधे से ज़्यादा जिंदगी खुश हो जाती है उन लोगों की, उन लोगों को सिर्फ चाहिए कोई सुनने वाला, तो मैं यहीं पे विराम लेता हूँ एंड थैंक यू सो मच।
शेयर विथ यू वन इंसिडेंस इन वार्ड नंबर 8, दिस वाज माय फर्स्ट पोस्टिंग, इट वाज सर्जरी अंडर डॉक्टर एस ए राव यूनिट, सो इट वाज ट्यूसडे मॉर्निंग 9 o'clock एंड इट वाज द केमो डे, सो इट वाज लाइक अ ड्रेडफुल डे फॉर अस because we had to put around 20-25 IVs in the morning, send HBCBC samples for all these patients, and in the afternoon we are supposed to give them the chemo that has been prescribed by the registrars and the housing. So our job was to make sure that we put the IV properly and we ensure that the chemo is done at the end of the day. So before going for lunch at 12:30, we had to make sure that all IV lines are in situ and all the samples have been sent. It was my first posting, it was my second day, posting started on Monday, so I did not know how to put an IV yet and I was just learning. The houseman was Kush Parikh and he was very helpful and he was teaching me how to put an IV and all. After I had been to ward in second year and in third year thanks to strict medicine postings and so I had actually learned putting an IV in second year. That helped me on my first day. My IVs went smooth. There was a co-intern sitting next to me who fired almost every vein that she got. And the patients get a little worried ki are yaar ye doctor ko nahi aa raha hai and ye doctor ko aa raha hai. So I'll go to him. And then suddenly the whole line comes to me. And and then I'm putting all IVs. Out of 24, about 20 I got. Two patients had very bad veins. You know, the chemotherapeutic agent, it destroys the endothelium. So the veins become very bad. Sometimes they become black and hardened because they're thrombosed. And then you think that this is the vein and you put the cannula in and there is no blood coming and there's no flow. So about 2-3 were left. So Kush taught me how to do an external jugular vein cannulation on the same day. So this is my second day and I am learning both IVs and then one EJV in the first day. Okay. One of the IVs, in the afternoon, went for lunch, came back. In the afternoon, when I was there in the ward, one of the patient's drip was not, the flow was not going. So mostly the IV was blocked. I tried to flush it with normal saline, it was still blocked. I had put that IV in cubital vein because I couldn't find it anywhere else. But in breast cancer patients, one hand is, you cannot use it for IVs. So only one hand and the whole vein is thrombosed below the forearm and one IV put in the cubital vein, which was fired now. So. And I started talking to her, मॅम माझं पेशंटला की काकू माझा पहिलाच दिवस आहे आणि असं तसं आहे लिटल अफ्रेड अँड नॉट गेट नोईंग हाऊ टू टॉक टू पेशंट्स. द रिप्लाय ऑफ दॅट पेशंट वॉज सो अमेझिंग, अरे बाळा माझं आयुष्य संपलं आता, आता हे काय तुम्हाला शिकण्यासाठी आहे. And when she said that, I was like, okay, if she's ready to teach me, because she's the patient, and patient is going to teach me. So this is what Lopa ma'am, Manu sir, and everyone in our colleges used to teach us. The meaning of everything was there in that one sentence, ki he sagala tumchyasathi chalu hai. And we were like, I have to put 20 IVs and I'm not able to find that IV. So that changed to, I have to learn how to put an IV very efficiently and very nicely in that one sentence. So you will find patients, if you start talking to them, they talk to you. It's like a mirror in between you and the patient. Thank you.
We will be announcing the winning entries of online competitions. I know it's late, but I think they can be conveyed. And the winning entries will also be displayed on our Facebook page. So please do follow. I would request just 5 minutes, you guys, to settle down. Just 5 minutes. So for photography competition, the first prize is Karthikeya Gavli. Anyone? Yeah, the theme for this was happiness. And this is a picture depicting about saving of water and offering. Save water and offer water and save birds.
I'm just interpreting.
Okay. The second prize is by Bhumika Maru. I would like to call upon Dr. Lopa Mehta ma'am to present the certificate to Bhumika. Bhumika.
The main theme was happiness, and for me, I really like children. So it was most like ki the real meaning, the simplest and the purest form of happiness is children. So the entire theme was.
The first prize for art is won by Prachiti Shete. The theme of this competition was breaking the stereotypes. And this art piece describes the challenges of a human being as like of a male and female about the society stereotypical problems, like a girl who can be like body shame for body hair or stretch marks, or she may be just limited to be a housewife, or a male in which we just stereotype them as they don't cook, or they are just destined to play and earn and not for house jobs. So this is a photo describing breaking of stereotypes in a very descriptive pattern. The second prize is won by Neha Parikh. For the innovative ideas, first prize is won by Dr. Arnav Tongaukar sir, in which he had explained about a website called Connect, in which it will form as a social media platform so as to put all the doctors together and the rest of the details will be revealed on the Facebook post. The second prize is about application of microRNA mediated gene silencing in human diseases including cancer, and this entry is won by Tuhina Mishra from JJ Hospital. For essay writing, the first prize is won by Sanvida Satpute. Her entry will be released on Facebook. And the topic for the essay was sexuality, section 377, sexuality isn't a trend but ignorance seems to be. And the second prize for this is won by Madhura Nagaukar. Her entry will also be revealed on Facebook. Thank you. I would like to extend a warm thanks and gratitude to Dr. Lopa Mehta ma'am and Dr. Padmaja Samant ma'am for giving us students the opportunity to organize Ascension a step about 2019. I would also like to thank all my team members for being so supportive and helping to raise this conference. I assume that throughout these 3 years, Ascension is growing, and I hope that next year also we have such a bang conference. Thank you.